Hello everyone, I'm Mr. Mokelover, and thank you for joining me here at the start of a new campaign in Old World Blues 3.1.1, and we are playing in Texas. As you can tell from the thumbnail, maybe from the title, we're playing as a certain nation. Now, with this campaign, I'm going to turn off historical AI focuses just to see what happens, and custom game rules, it's going to be crazy. Completely random, I don't know what's going to happen, you probably don't know what's going to happen, but let's begin as Shale's army. Now, it's been recommended I take a certain path, maybe a certain curious purchase path, but the mods we're using for this campaign include Old World Blues, Old World Blues Radio, a State Chancellor Tool mod, Player-led Peace Conferences, as well as Colored Events, if I remember correctly. Only five mods. Only five for now. But we're playing as Shale's army, led by, of course, Mr. Shale, and sometimes this just takes forever to load. Old World Blues, why? Still not as bad as TNO, but that's totally okay. Okay, so we are in Texas. And, oh, there's a Pip-Boy stuff. Our national spirits include Attis Army Remnants, which we get more population, as well as outpost construction speed. National focus. Let's do Remnants of Attis' Army. Attis, more than any other mutant, was ambitious. That's pretty quick. So, we currently have three research slots. Our tech levels are pretty okay. It's a mix between civilized and tribal, so, yeah, it's okay. Let's see, rural technologies. We currently have super mutant civilization, so we lose infantry, attack, and defense. Well, that's a good thing we're not really going to be using them then. Let's grab some research speed. That'd be good. Let's go ahead and grab some combat language. And grab some work as needed. Now, this is my first campaign and where we will eventually be using, not this stuff, but Outsider Whiffer. I'm really excited to use that because this is my first time using it, so I don't know what's going to happen. So, I've tried this a little bit off screen as well before. And going the path that we want to, or just playing as Shale's army, isn't particularly super easy. Let's see, we're using melee equipment, that's totally fine with me. Some support equipment would be nice. Make, let's see, bigger number means better wins, right? Bigger number equals better wins. Cool, thank you. We're gonna need a lot of this, and we're gonna need a lot of this. Yeah, we're gonna need a lot of these guys for what we're gonna do in this campaign. A lot of super mutants and Attis army remnants. Oh, it's 10 combat, which isn't bad, but it is what it is. Cool, we let the time go on. Disable backstory decisions, because we don't really need to see that. And we make about 9.99 caps. Really, 9 caps. So, if you need to read about the caps in 3.0 update, go right ahead. But I have a pretty good feeling of how to play with 3.0 update, thanks for the 1 cap, and Remnants of Attis' Army. Attis was a super mutant without equal, intelligent, cruel, cunning. When the Master fell, they had led an army east, away from the Brotherhood and the growing Californian Republic, hoping to find some answers as to the origin of the FEV. This origin would eventually be found in the city of Los, near somewhere known as a secret vault. There, ultimately, is where he would have met his end, the army fracturing shortly after into several subgroups. We served under them in their army as one of the lieutenants. What did Attis value in us to trust us so highly? Our strategy, which is okay. Our cunning, we get worse for, which is not bad. Or our loyalty. Now, there's one thing about me, I'm very loyal. Usually. And I like stability. Stability is a very nice thing. Our assignment. The mission he sent to us, to him, was the most important. And we shall be led by right now. The Masticator? Conquer Siwek. Kwek. Well, they're both Psi. S-I. Yeah, they're both intelligent. But he's level 3, so we gotta go with the level 3, dude. Cool. And you should be led by someone else. And just go and buddy up against those guys. That'd be fine. And the next focus shall be done very, very soon. Before Attis met his end, he gave us an assignment to follow. He tasked us to ensure that if he met his end within the secret vault to carry out his mission, leading from Fort Stockton and trying to gather what remains of the army together. What supplies would Attis have left us to accomplish this task? Construction equipment or ammunition? Now, normally, I like to go with construction equipment. However, because I know what will happen eventually, and we need to pump out a lot of divisions, even one more arms workshops is exactly what we need. And if you didn't know, this picture of Attis is actually, I believe, from the art of, what was it, Fallout Brotherhood of Steel 2? I might have been looking up thumbnail ideas and saw his image. Anyways, our legacy. We've accomplished much since his end. And look at Shale. So smug. Maybe not smug, but he's an isolationist if you didn't know. He's kind of okay. He knows what's going on. But we have followed Attis' last request to the letter, having spent the last 80 years since his death building up a massive army to the south in preparation for the unification of his army. To his east and south, the other way, where generals don't seem as willing to follow orders. Are they being treasonous? We will show them the strength of his vision by force if necessary. And Shale becomes the loyal general, which we get more mobilization speed. And now we can follow in Attis' footsteps. And here's a focus tree. It's not huge, by any means. That's all it is. But we shall follow in his footsteps. Attis was a legend among mutants, one of the greatest generals who served under the Master himself, a titan of a figure who led his army east in hopes of finding a future for humankind. Ultimately, he met his end somewhere within the secret vault, but that just means he ended his campaign in honor. Shia wants nothing more in life than to emulate his predecessor and become just as great of a hero as he was. Truly a great hero. Cool, so, we need divisions. We need divisions out the booty. Because we need to go to war with Carbon as Los. And these guys are not particularly weak. Ooh, High Priestess Sappho. Hello there. Church of the Lost. Lost. We have Vice City, which looks pretty good. And then they also have Advance. Cool, that's not bad. Do they have unique focus tree? No, they do not, which is fine. And Carbon, led by, Mayor Jasmine. She's charismatic. Thumbs up from me. Scavenger City, Clean Water. Scavenger City Advanced, so... Also, a generic focus tree, but hey, you know what? Sometimes we gotta get that. We got 1.17 political power every single day, and right now we're making some civilian factories, but like I said, having one more civilian factory here really won't matter too much, since you go from 2 to 3. That's not gonna really help out that much. If you get one more military factory now, you can make slightly more basic melee weaponry every single day, which I think is pretty good. Alright, so, and we're done with following in Attis' footsteps. And it was recommended for me to play Shale's army and go down this route first. A curious purchase, and I will play a Shell's army again with garb fit for general, but a curious purchase. We have some caps laying around, let's spend them on a curiosity. A merchant from Los is willing to sell us a rather peculiar tech or shop tech vending terminal, which he claims is from the secret vault itself. Curious, I do say so myself. I wonder what we're gonna get. And also, with military policies, we have no other conscription law. We have forceful mission, in which we get more population, we lose stability, resistance target, and more daily compliance, which is pretty nice actually. And we got some other things, but what do we have here? Oh, yeah, that's fine. We must have built our ship. Cool. The Desert Rangers declare one of the Jackals. Well, that's pretty normal. Lanius Cohort declare one Blue Rose Society. We'll see what happens with Ahistorical. Juggernaut, the Bale Slayer. Organization, enemy retreat chance, naval lineage. That's all right. Go ahead and train until you die. Good, good, good. And we're going to get a lot of naval XP, which hopefully we do not need to use. Actually, how's this? Cool. The Braxos Corridor. That's right. That's cool. Alrighty, tidy. Yeah, we're going to need a lot of divisions where we're headed. So, decryption is good. But let's go ahead and grab some improvised tools. Actually, no. I want to go with my land auction immediately. Specialized auction. Thank you. You know what? I'm kind of glad they did not put Outsider Warfare on the same page as here, because you won't be able to see it nearly as much. So, if you shake the screen a lot, left, right, at least it fits under specialized doctrine. So, that's actually a really smart decision. Outsider Warfare. Let's get some more soft attack and organization. Nice. Oh, yeah. Actually, it's exclusive with automated warfare, conventional warfare, asymmetric warfare, refined warfare, and specialized warfare. Interesting. Very peculiar, I would say. Let's see, we have political power, we could get more stability. I think we probably want to get some more stability, especially where we're headed. But first, I'm going to grab Military Theorist, Outsider Warfare, Land Doctrine, Troy, Stonewall. And we're going to grab Rad, Pyromaniac, so that we can get more army XP. So we can increase our division combat width. And get through our land doctrine as quickly as possible. So, a curious purchase. Setting up your new shop tech terminal. A shop tech terminal is an amazing little thing, capable of accepting any purchase you request of it. A purchase is, per the instruction booklet included, a verbal request of 20 words or less. Notably, this system in particular has been upgraded with an AI found on a particular holotape, a protocol known as CALIX. Using this terminal, we can effectively make any sort of purchase we require, almost as if the machine is an ancient genie of old, able to answer whatever wish it's given. It sounds too good to be true. It might be, of course, after all. These purchases will need to be paid for. Perhaps it's worth it. I'm too busy for this. Let our soldiers deal with it, which is not bad. Or CALIX would be my personal steward. We will gain a new, unique field marshal and AI subroutine known as CALIX. CALIX will assist us for as long as we need, but will require that we make payments in the form of various things our nation has in return for the services. These trades are not often in our benefit, CALIX being a very high maintenance protocol. Once it's begun, it cannot be stopped. Consider this hard mode. Continue. Oh, you know I am. Oh, hello! Welcome to Shop Tech. A computerized trading system, an advanced experimental vending machine to help you get the equipment that you will need for daily post-apocalyptic living. With the aid of new CALIX protocols, this system will help you find what you are looking for to allow you to complete whatever physical, spiritual, or anecdotal purchases you may require during your meager, pathetic, corporeal existence. I do most look forward to working with you. Purchase request, help me find Attis. Let's see, purchase FEV? The Path to Glory, yes. Because that unlocks these other focuses, so we'll do that one, the Path of Glory. The Path of Glory was what Attis called the fate of the super mutants, a one-way road of conquest, death, and victory. Many mutants accept this fate, that their kind is numbered and ultimately doomed to extinction, yet Attis always seemed to be contemplative of this fate, as if somewhere near the end of this road would be the true fate of mutant kind, one not of oblivion, but of evolution. Also, it's really cool, because you go to military policies with mutant instinct, it's basically the same things with Dumb Dumb, Second Generation Training, First Generation Training, and Children of the Master. It's just like the other one with like normal like humans, but it's really cool that they actually made this unique for super mutants too, so I think that's really awesome. Rad Power Maniac? Yes! Great. 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 Yeah, we need a lot of guns. Or, not guns, infantry equipment. Actually, we probably can't buy guns, or infantry equipment, or whatever we have. Water's pretty good, but we have no trade node to trade, get more stuff from. Which is quite unfortunate, but you know, it is what it is. We have about 2 weeks left for that. We got about a week left for reference manuals, which is not bad. I would train. Oh, actually. Hey, CALIX. But we don't want to use CALIX because she has minus 50% leader experience gain. I mean, yeah, I can get inspirational, but that's not really worth it. I'd rather have conquered Siwik. Kuwik? Siwik? Oh, we got to go rooted, probably. Yeah, I'm going to go rooted. Because we need as much entrenchment as possible here. And to get Savage Leader, that'd be good. Alrighty, tidy. Let's grab some planes, actually, next. Gliders. We won't be able to make too many, but I'd still rather have them than not have them. Because even the AI uses gliders, so. Scavenging program. We could do that, but that costs cast of scavenger stuff, and I think we'll be okay for now. Good. Make more, more, more. Alright, Boral. So, top shop tech payment request. Hello! This is a bit of a big request, but I'm going to need some of your friends to move in with me. My mainframe is growing at a rate that is difficult to keep myself from constantly falling apart without constant supervision. I am such a wreck and I could kill somebody right now. Please dispense payment as required. Oh, wow. So we lose a civilian workshop, but 20% chance of adding a logistic skill. 100 experience. Oh, crud. Wait, hold on. Does that mean, like, who gets a skill? 5 armies. Well, I guess she got 100 XP, but I guess we got nothing out of that. Okay, well, whatever. That wasn't very good for us. And, hello, my sensors have detected that your band of post-apocalyptic thugs are currently close to my former place of residence. As payment, I will need you to take me there before anywhere else. Really? I blocked you from taking the focus conquering Carbon before you control Los. So, if we go to war with Los, we have to go to war with Carbon, which is not very good. I'm going to go ahead and grab Mutant Scavenging for more output would be really good right now. Mutant Industry would not be bad. Behemoths of Industry would be kind of nice, actually. Fortification Battalion for even more population. Over here, this just helps you mostly with more construction speed, research speed, factory output, which isn't bad, but... Meh. Let's go do this one actually, you know what? I'm going to do this one first, just so we have it available whenever we need it. Los is where Attis met us, and ultimately, a dark city of deranged, crazy ghouls who preached a faith of insanity and oblivion. If Attis was alive, they would never have been around to today. Let's fix that, shall we? And I want to do this, but we don't have enough factories for that, which really sucks. Yeah, I'm really... Ooh, 8 divisions. We're going to need at least 10 to do well. Because, I mean, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5... Oh, wait, hold on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 divisions at the minimum. Just to have an okay line against these guys. So we need at least 9. I'm going to shoot for at least 15. Because we're going to need at least 2 divisions per some tiles. Especially if we're fighting 2 different nations at once. Because Los is guaranteed by Carbon. And Los has how many divisions? Up to 10. Carbon has up to 4, which isn't bad. But we only have 8 divisions right now. We could get involved, but I want to play it a little bit safe. I want to make sure that we have a good enough army, and it doesn't take too much for us to train these guys, so... We're only missing 1,000 pieces of equipment, which isn't bad, but especially if we work as needed, let's grab some improvised tools, so that would be very good, help us get even more output right now. 4.6 a day is not bad, and we're making some support equipment as well. Very good. Very, very good. And I'm not even going to train these guys, so... Oh, crud. Hello, I've sent some corruption in your governmental body, and I've taken the initiative calling them for you, no need to thank me. We lose 20% or 10% stability. Oh my gosh. Putting the kibosh on them. Let's go on mutant scavenging. There's a lot to be found in the remnants of the old world. Things far more advanced than we can produce. Yet, even just a little bit of study can yield insight on how to recreate these relics. More construction speed, research speed, and output, which is something we could really, really use right now. Oh, Shale. After that, I think I'm probably going to go down to well-equipped army. We probably need to make sure this goes a little bit faster and get our own factories back. So, that'd be good. Yeah, but this shouldn't take too long. We got another one coming along. What are we missing here? Just not enough equipment to train, huh? But hey, 4.6 days, not bad, but... CALIX hurts me. Why does she hurt me so badly? Hey! 9 divisions, nice! If anything, really, you don't need to move that much, so you go right there. So now we need 900 some. Woof! That's a lot. That's quite a bit. And we've already reached our efficiency cap. Or almost did. Yeah, we've almost reached it, which kind of sucks, but whatever. Support equipment, not bad, though. Not bad. And let's go over here and grab, actually, anything over here. Settlement builder, that's okay. Factory output is not bad. Built tough. Built forward tough. What about down here? Slaving bastardino. Consuming hunger. Slave master, I don't mind those. Over here, though, thumb face. Battle master. Old soldiers, not bad. I like that one. Brains and bronze, not bad. And this one's pretty good. Warmonger as well. And over here, we got power of hunger. Okay, not bad. Power of might, which is okay. So I'm just going to grab this then. I think that will benefit us the most, probably, out of all that stuff. Balloons, we can grab that stuff. Let's grab some more, or less division training time. Not bad. We lost 10% more stability. Why? Why do you hurt me? CALIX, why? Mutant scavenging, not bad. We can purchase FEV. Mutant Industries. What would that give us? A bonus for that. We get another civilian slot. I kind of wish we had another... Oh, we get another arms workshop right there. That's not bad. I kind of don't mind having that. Fabrication stuff. Let's get some more output first. So far, our initiative towards scavenging the waste has borne fruit. We have now greater access to vehicles, both for the purpose of war making and industry. And with the promise of dangerous weapons to be found lost amongst the rubble, more mutants are drawn away from the front and into the ruins. We get 4% more construction speed, 2% more research speed, and 4% more output. And I want that output as much as possible, so we can make more and more and more divisions. As long as we can hold on defense, we will be okay. I hope. And I really hope... No one else goes to war with us anytime soon. Hope so. We're rooted. Anything else? Gun nut. Organization loss when moving. I'm also going to grab rooted here because I am worried that we're only 10 combo with divisions. Ooh, it's not going to be great. Nerd rage. I guess that'd be okay. It's level 3, which isn't bad. Still 9 divisions. How much longer is it going to take for us to get these guys out? Come on, just make more guns. Hey, that's not bad. Minus 800. Could be so much worse. We got about 10 days left, which is not bad. After that one, I want even more output. While they're highly beneficial to us, our efforts and the wasteland have been mostly ad hoc and without any set standards or procedure. As we continue to draw prospectors and pull technological marvels out of the rubble, we should make at least some effort to reorganizing the Riley bands of scavengers in a meaningful way. We lose 105 political power. Are you kidding me? Good lord. That's so much. Hey, 4.2 though. That's better. Minus 700 some? That's okay. That's totally okay, but... Oh, I don't like CALIX. I don't like her that much. Is she getting more experience, though? Is that okay? How's she doing? Well, she's got level 3. That's not bad. That's really not bad. I don't like the AI assistant, though. That's really not good. Perceptive, charismatic, intelligent. That's nice and all, but... You hurt us. Please don't hurt us. Minus 54 political power already. My goodness. That's just so not good. After that, let's see. Can we do that one? Yes, we can. 8% more factory output? Why not? Our efforts to find knowledge and resources in the waste has given us insight into just about all the scientific fields. It's taken us to new heights and deeper depths than anything ever before. The scavenger is a new and proud cast of mutant society and makes excellent time in bringing us fabled treasures of the old world. 8% factory output and construction speed is nothing to laugh at. And then plus 2% more research speed? That's not bad. It's not great, but that's not bad. I'm really here for even more output, because now we have 12 divisions. Whoa! Crusher's army. Whoa, that's kind of crazy, but okay. Even though I guess the factory output really isn't helping us that much, but we do have 12 divisions. That's not bad. If anything, actually, I'm going to make sure that this is a little bit more strewn out like this. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So we have 12 divisions. If they have three there, yeah, I don't know. But doing this is pretty good. Outsider Warfare, Mutated Endurance, get 0.15 more, 0.15 better recovery rate, which is not bad. Not bad. Invest in a small business, more construction speed and factory output. We lose 15 caps. Oof. 15% more output. Is it really worth it for that? I don't know about that, man. Oh, we can get some planes, too. I like that. Let's get some planes if we can as well. That's good. 10 days left. 13, 12. We can do that one. And then we'll probably go purchase FEV so we can get that done. Maybe. Mutant Industry. What's down here? Oh, my goodness. We remove another civilian workshop. Oh, come on, man. Come on. That means I'm going to do this one next. One of the first and most important aspects of a modern state, especially in the wasteland, is the ability to organize a cohesive and directed industrial effort. Being a nation of giant green people does nothing to change this fact. We get a double research bonus for industrial technology, and it seems like the world is falling apart. This is only 20 days. Oh, that's not bad. And the Troll Warner at War as well. Improvised tools, good. Raise that cap. We could do that. I'm going to grab some woodworking as well right now. How close are we? We're not even close at all. Oh my goodness. I just want to get a few more divisions out, because we will be able to hopefully hold the line, because this is dangerous. Level 4 divisions, that's quite a bit over here. That's quite a bit. 4, 4, 3, that is a lot. If that's the case, I'm going to go and build up like 2 forts here. Well, does it take too long? It takes us like 3 months, though. Oh, my goodness. Oh, we just barely got positive political power. I promise you, by the end of this episode, we will be at war, so. Because you never know if anyone else is going to go to war with us as well, so. Alright, after that 15 days, I'm going to go for mutant workshops. No, the red ones go faster for another arms workshop. It would be negligent to not consider out capability for assembling and housing aircraft of all kinds. The paving of airfield and construction of hangars coupled with the christening of new military factories will help us cover our aerial bases. Not really too worried about the airbase, but the arms workshop, yeah, we can get some gliders. Oh god, stop it. Remove, oh, that's not too bad. Remove 3 scrap. This could be worse. Oh yeah, and oh, you probably can't join the army here. Yeah, I could manually. Oh, we can still do that. Cool. Very good. Very good. We do have enough army XP, but we just don't have enough infantry equipment. Hey, we got 5 a day. That's not bad. I like that a lot. 5 a day is not bad. Where you're training? I'm gonna grab. That's really important. I like this. I like the blue guns. Blue Deagle, blue weaponry, advanced weaponry, elite weaponry. Nice. Can we even get down here? Yeah, we can actually. We can't get down here, though, because we're not advanced. That advanced. Support equipment. Oh, we're going to need some support equipment. We're going to need some anti-tank eventually, but I want to get over to this first. Yeah, secret language. Let's do that one first. Archdiocese was annexed. So be it. So be it. Oof. 5.02 a day. Oh. Not looking good for us. 13 divisions is not bad, though. Even though... Actually, are you guys making any divisions over here? It's really low, so that I'm worried about. You guys are up to 7. They have up to 20 divisions. What the heck? Regardless, something to drink. There goes hand warband. More population, outpost, construction speed. Mutant workshops wouldn't be bad. Less factory consumption. More armed workshops. Mutant workshops. Super mutant factory workers have a unique set of needs and strengths. The construction of civilian industries in which these people can both produce new buildings and consumer goods, which will create a solid steel backbone for which our industry can rest upon. Not bad. I'm glad we got that army XP, so. Hey, only minus 700 some until we, you know, pop out some new divisions, which we will have the new division soon. That'd be good. That'd be very, very good. Yeah, these guys are going to need some more. 4, 5, 4. Jesus, yeah. They'd be able to smash this guy easily. Which is why I'm not attacking yet. It just... We're going to need more stability, though. Do we grab more stability? Umbra? Ooh, yeah. Probably stability is the way to go for now. I don't mind lowering my research speed. It's only minus 5%, which is not bad. 10 days... Not bad. Secret language. Because after that, I'm going to just immediately go for local workspaces. Because you get more max factories in a state, but more base, retention, but especially that output. Which I think is probably the most important thing. It looks like we made at least one plane, which is not bad. It's not going to help us out much. Hey, you got 16 divisions up. Mutant workshops. Nice. Mutant arms factories. Old world assembly lines aren't really fit to construct some weapons of the proper size and scope for a super mutant. This shortcoming means that we should shore up our own military industry with new arms factories that can keep pace with the needs of an FEV improved army. Stop it. Oh, we just... 10% more? Are you kidding me? We get 0.85 a day. Are you kidding me? Ah. How many do we need? That's actually not too bad. Yeah, this is hurt by... Our production is hurt by our lack of stability. Oh, why do you hurt me? Why? Why do you hurt me so much? We got about 20 days left, which is totally fine with me. Oh, look at that. We have this modifier. Oh, yeah, 20% output, construction speed, and 8% more research speed, which isn't bad. Hey, did we actually make something here yet? Oh, yeah, they're killing each other, which is good. Did we actually make it? Oh, yeah, we did. We have level 1 fort there, which isn't going to help us that much when there's so many divisions over there, but whatever. Yeah, I said 15 divisions. Yeah, we're going to need more than that. We're definitely going to need more than that. All right, after that one, we are going to do Clear Sky Connection, Super Mutant Tool. Yeah, we'll probably do this one. Tools built for regular people have a tendency to break and become unwieldy in mutant hands. With a bit of design work and standardization across our factories, we'll equip workers with tools they can depend on and use to build a better future. Minus so much political power. If that's the case, I'm going to spend it on here first. No, not yet. We need more than 4 can be used for projects. Oh, I got to use it for something else. No. Construction speed. I'm going to do this one. I need the output. We just need it. There's nothing I can spend political power on, is there? I'm going to lose it in 10 days. I'm not going to lower my war support, though. There's no way I'm going to lower my war support. Oh, man. Why do you hurt me? No, I'm not touching it. Nope. Can't force me to touch it. No. So we got about a week left. That's fine. How many are we missing right now? 700. That's not bad. 6.6 is not bad. Oh. Again with a pain. Why? At least we got some woodworking. That's good. We'll grab some basic tools next. Get some output. And then we got to go keep doing our mutant endurance. Recovery rate's not bad, though. They have more divisions online, but that's fine with me. It doesn't really matter. Come on, make more divisions. So after that, Clear Sky Connections, Behemoths of Industry really wouldn't be bad. Oh, a lucrative opportunity. Border war to take the state down there, but, with these guys, huh? How strong is TAA? We have more divisions than them. They have a lot of manpower. Ooh, I'm not really sure which one to do. Ooh, we can get more infantry equipment. Let's grab that one. So, one of the things that the Wasteland is full of and we like more than anything else is DACA. Big ones, little ones, automatic ones, explosive ones, we can't get enough of them. While being both the backbone of our army and the main incentive for mutees to pick through the rubble, shiny new shooters are truly a prize to behold. It's only 250 more pieces of infantry equipment, but I will gladly take them. Hey, look, mutant-sized tools. Some more cap, more growth, conversion speed bonus, which we're probably not going to use too much, and consumer goods factories goes down. So hey, we're almost done with that too. Mutated experience, so we can now get mutated strength mastery. More breakthrough, soft attack, and hard attack. Don't mind if we do. 0.91, that could be a lot worse, actually. Daka, 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 daka. Hey, that's not bad. Minus 645, 17 divisions. Still not enough down here, though. So you're done with that stuff. I'm going to go ahead and do this as well. Boom, boom. So you'll be done in 4 months, or 3 months. Oh my goodness. March, April, June, July, 4 months. Oh my goodness. Yeah, I'm just not worried about these guys. These are the guys I'm really worried about. It was better to go to war with them early on, but... they don't have that much manpower. They don't have a lot of divisions either. All that matters... Hey, 19 divisions, though. Hey, it's not bad. Right? It's not bad. 2, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 2, 2, 2. Local workspaces are good. Grab some more clay working. That'd be good for even more construction speed, because we're going to need that right now. So... Minus 750. Oh, no, no. Oh, my... We already are hurt from your other... Support equipment is not bad. We don't really need that, though. Fortification battalions. Yeah, we could do that. Now to drop to drink. More infrastructure. Purchase stuff. Organizing groups of able-bodied mutants into fortification battalions will allow us to fast-track the construction of outposts along our more troublesome borders, and with the added bonus being that these souls can be conscripted into general service. Yeah, I guess so. How close are we to making other divisions? Let's get at least one more division, and then I'll go to war. We'll see what happens when we do go to war. It's not going to be pretty. It's not. It just ain't. I'm going to send you up here immediately, because you're going to get smashed, and you're going to get smashed up here, too. Which is exactly something I do not want to have. Especially with still a deficit of infantry command. Hey, we got 20 divisions, so that's not too bad. No, you got to come up here, son. Even with three up here, you still might get smashed. No, you stay there. What are you doing? No. Oh my goodness, are you... You guys are stupid. You guys are dumber than rocks. Land is this cohort. So be it, so be it. Mojave Territory is clear with the Mojave Brotherhood. Cool. I don't know why you're so dumb down there. I mean, maybe they could attack through here and do okay, but... How strong are these ghouls? They're just ghouls. They don't have any other equipment on them, which is not bad. Ooh. Minus 300. Hey, 9 a day. That's not bad. Fortification battalions. And then we're going to grab... Convoys... fighters. That's not bad. That's not bad. Airplane engineering is complicated for normal humans, but without any specialists and pilots that are about twice as big in every aspect, it really starts to become a... Sisyphean science. Though a nation with active and effective air power is one that can win wars with far greater is one than without, so we should endeavor to use what we can from older designs to build our own planes. We don't get a lot of planes. 150, which will come in handy, of course. And we are raising our conscription level too, so that's not too bad. At least get one more fort around here, because two divisions is not going to be enough to hold. That's just absolutely not going to be able to hold. I could, like, deploy soldiers early, but that would not be very smart, either. Just not very smart at all. And I'll end the episode as soon as we go to war. But we're not going to go to war yet. So we got some time. Right, another division made. Basic tools. Get that output going, 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 going. Doing well down there. Let's grab some seed selection. Actually, no. I'm going to grab this. No, that's a little bit ahead of time. Maybe not. Ooh. Train mongrels. Healing powder. Da, da, da. All this stuff is not bad. We're going to need some anti-tank, though, eventually. Land doctrine. Specialized doctrine. Air stuff. Seed selection it is. What are we missing right now? Well, crap, we're missing scrap. Are you kidding me? Hey, less than 300 needed. That is very good, actually. Our shortage will last only for a month. And even though we haven't raised our conscription level yet, or I mean, I should really say edit our armies, that's not bad. And the longer we wait, actually, we get another fort down here, which is good. And maybe another fort over here. And we can always move this division over here to be 3, so we can 3 and 3, which might be able to hold out, maybe. Oh my god, why? I can't do anything with you. No. I'm not clicking you. Scour the airfields, not bad. Ooh, civilian specialization. Which one should we do, guys? Hawkish specialization for captain research speed, or civilian specialization. Max factories in a state or research speed. Let me know in the comments below. Which one should we take? And next up we're gonna do... That stuff is okay. Mutant mining operations. Mutants have an excellent physique for mining. Strong back, tall, can carry a ton of weight without even breaking a sweat. With even minimal effort, we could... Crack the Texas soil open and begin to plunder its mineral riches for self. Cool. Come on. Less than... Wow, we're almost at a minus 100. That's... Oh, never mind. 22 divisions. It's not bad. Oh, where are you actually going? Oh, you're actually going to go up to the right place. Hey, not bad. Oh, we got 23 divisions now. Nice. Oh, I'm on minus 130. Why? That is so god-awful. I'll be honest. That is so bad. Pressures. Oh, they actually won. Oh, they finally won, actually. Oh, boy. Minus 260. Minus 250. Jesus. They were 2276 June. Minus 210. Probably done with that. Not bad, not bad. Yeah, this one, get this one done quickly. Oh, construction. Oh, we almost have the fort here. We almost have a fort. Which still might not be enough for us. God, making forts take so long. Whew. Less than 200, though. Nice. Oh, stop it. Oh, we need the scrap, though. We need the scrap. What is your problem? CALIX, stop. Stop. Twin Mothers, a clear warm circle junction. Hey, now you can have the scrap. Cool. All's well. That well's well. Irradiated water from either the Gulf or its tributaries generally isn't safe to drink, but water dug out from 100-year-old aquifers is almost entirely cured of its radioactive kiss. Though normal mutants generally don't mind a bit of spicy water for the purposes of managing hummies and trading, it's better to start digging out the clean stuff. Make it more infrastructure, which is actually pretty nice. Hey, only minus 200, and we have a full stack of 25 divisions. Not bad. Who are you? So, at this point, we don't even have command power. I'm going to... Level 5 defense. You know what? As much as I don't want to use you, you're actually not bad. So, for here... There you go. Now spread out like you need to. What? Why are you going all the way over... What the heck? Where the hell are you going? You're all going to come right here. Why are you leaving? You need at least 3 divisions minimum over there. Who in their right mind would leave that tile? Hey, this guy got a lot of that naval XP. What the hell are you doing? Why are you abandoning? Oh, I see why. That's why. Because you have to have a fallback line. That's why. You have to have one. Oh, that sucks. 3-3-3-3. Alright, let's look at these guys organized. Maybe we can defend here effectively. Oh, this is gonna suck so much. Hey, but only minus 500. Oh my gosh. Are you serious? I think we've waited long enough. Let's go ahead and... Do we not even have an air... Oh, we do have an air base. That's okay. That's good. Let's get them deployed, and it's just time to go. It's time to go. Braxis Corridor. Another division. Well, it was nice knowing all y'all. Clay working. And... 0.44. That's just a little bit of 2 at a time. What should we research first? I'm thinking... We could use healing powder. We could use recon. It's not bad. Not bad. Not great, but not bad. Dogs would be good. Dynamite. I think we might want to go with anti-tank rifles. You never can go wrong with this. Oh, and they immediately begin attacking us like crazy. Oh my goodness, you got to get over there. You know what? I might do... Oh, they're actually attacking us. If that's the case, you might be able to come over here quickly enough and do some damage, but... Let's see what happens. You guys help the attack, because half you guys are going to go immediately right there, straight to carbon. But we're going to end today's episode there, guys. Even though we have just begun the war, it is about time for us to see whether we win or die. But regardless, I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, consider leaving a like, subscribe if you're new, check out my Discord link in the description below, and I'll see you tomorrow, when we're going to try to hold out as hard and as best as we can against Los and Carbon. Thanks for watching, though, and have a great rest of your day.